Hi everyone, welcome back to our new tutorial. Hope you guys are well.
This is our WordPress series. In this series, I will discuss everything about WordPress and only about WordPress. If you are new in this field and thinking about to start with WordPress, then I will suggest you to follow this series from the beginning. In our previous tutorial, I showed you how you can install WordPress locally in your computer using XAMPP. You will find the link in the suggestion box. In this tutorial, I am going to show you how you guys can easily move WordPress website from local server to a live site.
And we will use Domainracer hosting service for hosting our website.
So before we start, if you guys are new in my channel, then please subscribe, like this video and press the bell icon for the future videos. And if you guys have any question about this video, you guys can comment below. So let's get started. One way to speed up your website development is to build your website locally on your computer using software like XAMPP and etc. Once you are finished perfecting your website, the next step is to move it from your computer to a live site and share your creation with the world. In this tutorial, I will show you how to easily move WordPress website from local server to a live site. And we can cover two different methods to move WordPress from local server to your live website. Method 1 is move WordPress from local server to a live site using a plugin. Method 2 is manually move WordPress from local server to a live site. So we will choose the easiest and the best way to complete this task. And that is method 1, move WordPress from local server to live site using a plugin. So for doing this, open your XAMPP software, click start, and then click admin. This will take you to your XAMPP admin panel. Now create a new tab, type localhost / and here you have to type your file directory name where you stored all of your local WordPress website files. For me, it will be my WordPress. Okay guys, let me show you my file directory where I have stored all of my WordPress files. So let's go to our my computer, then click on this local disk, and here you will find a XAMPP file. Open this file, and here you will find another file which is stdocs. Now open this file also. Here you guys can see that this is my file directory name, which is my WordPress, and in this file directory I have stored all of my WordPress files. So that's why here it will be my WordPress. Now click enter. So this is my file directory, which is wordpress_web. Now open this file. So now here you guys can see that this is the website which one I'm going to move from localhost to our live server. Now for host our website, we need a hosting service to make our website live. So for doing this, create a new tab and search for domainracer.com. I will use Domainracer hosting service for my website. Why? Because Domainracer is known for their cheap and best domain hosting with high speed and reliable service. There are so many web hosting companies out there, but the best part about Domainracer is cheap web hosting plans. Since 3 months, I am hosting my website at Domainracer. Before I choose Domainracer, I was gone through a lot of reviews and done enough research. Then I end up with Domainracer because they provide the best service under the budget. Obviously, they are the best hosting for beginner. I like Domainracer for 3 main reasons, that are great speed, low cost, and their customer support. So let's go to their website. So in their website here, you can see that cheap web hosting starting with $0.99 per month. See, $0.99, not even $1. I mean almost $1, but it's still $0.99. And here you can see that light speed technology, pure SSD disk space, free SSL certificate, and secure and faster. And here are the plans. Here you can see that basic starts with $0.99 per month, personal starts with $1.69 per month, silver starts with $2.9 per month, and advanced starts with $4.29 per month. And here are the features you will get for free while you are using their hosting service. And of course, you guys can check out their website. I will give a link in the description below. And now I will host my website in Domainracer. So first starts with our basic plan. Now click on this view more. And here you have to type a name for your website, and you can choose any one of these domain, and then you can check your domain name is available or not. And I already have a domain name from Domain Racer, so I will simply log in into my Domain Racer dashboard. After you filled up all of your information and payment process, you will be redirected to your Domain Racer dashboard. So now from here you can see that we have a service option, and from here you have to click on my service. So this is the domain name for my website. So now let's open my website. Here you can see that I don't have any data in my website because I didn't uploaded any website yet. So that's why. Now from here we have to click on active. And from here we have to go to our login to cPanel. And here in our cPanel we have to install our WordPress. So for doing this, scroll down. And in our script section, we have our WordPress. Now click on this WordPress. And from here, now we have to click on install now. And here you have to select your WordPress version, which one you are currently using. So mine is 5.6. And here you guys can choose any one, HTTP or HTTPS. So I will choose the HTTPS. And here this is my domain name. And here in our file directory, I will keep this field blank. Scroll down, and here you have to give your username. So my username is admin, and here you have to give your password. So my password would be 1 2 3 4 5 and 6. That's it. And scroll down, and from here you have to check limit login items and the classic editor. That's it. And from here you guys can choose any of the theme. So I will not choose any theme because I will upload my own theme. So that's why I will simply just click on this install button. So in a few seconds our WordPress will be installed in our cPanel. So now here you guys can see that I have successfully installed WordPress in our cPanel. And from here I will create two separate windows so that you guys can understand the changes. So in the left side we have our localhost, and in the right side we have our live server host. And here in our live server host, here you guys can see that here I have two URL. First one is for my website and second one is for my WordPress admin. So now let's open these two link. So this is my website. Here you guys can see that this is the website, but we don't have any content here yet because I didn't post anything here. And this is my WordPress dashboard. Now we have to move this website from our local host to our live server host. So for doing this, go to our local host, and here we have to go to our dashboard. And here in our WordPress dashboard, we have to go to our plugins, and then here we have to click add new. And here in our search option, we have to search for all-in-one WP migration. So here you guys can see that we have a plugin. Now we have to install this plugin in our localhost WordPress admin. Now click on this install now. So now here you can see that our plugin is now installed. Now we have to activate our plugin. So that's why I click on this active. So now here you guys can see that our all-in-one WP migration plugin is now activated. Now click on this bar, and from here you will find the plugin here, all-in-one WP migration. Now click on this, and from here we have to select export. And if we now scroll down, here we will find the option here. Now click on this option, and from here I want to export my website as a file. So that's why I click on this file. So now here you guys can see that our website has been now exported. Now we have to download this file. So that's why I click on this download button. Save this file. That's it guys. Now our website is now downloaded in our computer. Now we have to go to our live server and follow the same steps. So for doing this, go to our dashboard, and from here we have to go to the plugins, and here we have to click add new, and here we have to search for all in one WP migration. Now we have to install this plugin. So after installing our plugins, now we have to activate this plugin. Now let's go to our dashboard, and if from here you will find all-in-one WP migration plugin. Now click on this plugin, and then now we have to click on this import, and now here we have to click on import from, because I want to import from my desktop computer. So that's why I click on this import from, and here we have to select an option. In our localhost computer, I downloaded this website as a file, so that's why I have to select as a file. And then we have to select our file which we have downloaded from our localhost. Now select the file and click on this open. And this process can take time depending on your internet. So now guys, here you can see that our importing process is done. Now we have to click on proceed. So now guys, here you can see that we have successfully imported our website. Now let's click on finish. Now let's go to our live website. Let's refresh the page. So now guys, here you can see that our website is completely uploaded in a live website. So now let's see this. Here you can see that this is our website and this is looking good. And this is now in our live server, and we don't have any local host here. So now let's copy this link from here and create a new tab and paste our website URL and now enter. So now guys, here you can see that we have successfully moved our WordPress website from localhost to our live server, and that was so easy. And I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial, and if you guys really enjoyed this tutorial, then please subscribe, like this video and press the bell icon for the future videos. And if you guys have any question about this video, you guys can comment below. So let's see you guys in our next tutorial.